Nico and I have teamed up almost ever since high school, where we actually did, you know, class projects for literature or English class. And then we pursued, you know, degrees in film out in actually San Francisco, California.
What I enjoy about filmmaking for me specifically, because I'm behind the camera, is when we go location scouting for a shoot, I like to find a location that has natural light. And when the lighting is right, when you don't have to put any like lights or anything and set up anything like that, like it's really rewarding for me, you know. Mm-hmm. I hope that doesn't mean I'm lazy, though. You know, it's like you find the right spot and it's perfect. So that's what I kind of appreciate right now. That's what gets me excited, cinematography-wise. Yeah, our video showcased a lot of faces, and we wanted to kind of show the humanity of the event, and that's what I kind of focused on.
The one thing we do want people to take away with it is it's a really good recap or glimpse back as to something like this happened on Guam. And I think it's a reminder that, you know, for a moment in time, you know, all islanders, whether you were Guamanian or Pohnpeian or whatever, is that for that moment we were all just Pacific Islanders.
I think pride is the one thing that we got out of, or that we saw out of everyone, like, you know, all the different cultures that were there, including Guam.
I think you should just do it. Like, if you're an aspiring filmmaker, that you should just give it a go and just do it. I think the other thing too is, like, don't lose your voice. You know, a lot of critics out there will say what's good, what's bad, what's right and what's wrong, but I think it's really like you have your own edge and style to everything, so people may want to change it, but just keep true to what you want. And that's, you know, really real artistry. So just do it.
Honestly, yeah.
Simply close your eyes and allow yourself to hear all the sounds that are going on around you as if you were listening to music. Don't try to identify the sounds you're hearing. Don't put names on them. And simply let them go. The more, therefore, you relinquish power, trust others, the more powerful you become, but in such a way that instead of having to lie awake nights controlling everything, you do it beautifully by trusting the job to everyone else, and they carry it on for you. But the principle of unity, of coming to a sense of oneness with the whole of the rest of the universe, is not to try to obtain power over the rest of the universe. That will only disturb it and antagonize it and make it seem less one with you than ever. The way to become one with the universe is to trust it as another, as you would another, and say, let's see what you're going to do.